Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the next keynote speech of NETZSCH Analyzing and Testing. And again, we present the latest innovations in the field of thermal analysis. Specifically, we are talking about one method. And this method is related to speed. It's related to force and power. It's related to perfect control. It's, of course, related to ease of use. It's related to flexibility and usability. And it's related to temperature. And we are not talking about horses. We are talking about the latest innovations in dynamic mechanical analysis, DMA. What is a DMA doing? And let me show you this in a simple example here in a three-point bending setup. We bring a sample inside the instrument, and then we apply a force, an oscillating force, with a defined frequency, which we can change. And of course, we apply heat during a test. Again, we apply a force with an oscillating frequency, and then we can change temperature or time. What do we measure? We measure the stiffness of a material. Scientists call it the E prime or the G prime, which is a measure for the elastic response of a material. And I have a simple example on a wire here. So you bend the wire with a force, and you see the elastic deformation of the material. You can deform a material in another way, plastic deformation. And this we call the damping behavior of a material. Scientists call it the E prime, E double prime, or G double prime. Again, an example. When we do this on a wire, we can deform the wire plastically. And at a certain point, it will break. But before it breaks, the bending point gets warm. Plastic deformation means we transfer mechanical energy into heat. In many materials, both effects occur at the same time. NETZSCH has instruments for dynamic mechanical analysis since nearly 30 years. The DMA 242 Artemis. But now, we have a new one. And the new one is called the DMA 303 Eplexor, a laboratory unit which was improved in nearly all aspects related to dynamic mechanical analysis. I will only address a few of them. We address the frequency range. We address the force range. We talk about flexibility and usability. And of course, we talk about temperature range. Let's start with the first one. And the frequency range of the instruments was improved by 50%, which means we can get closer to your specific application with a real application and not with an extrapolation. Of course, frequencies are freely selectable, and you can do a frequency sweep, so do a measurement and measure at the same time at different freely selectable frequencies. And what is most important, you have this frequency range available without any gaps. There's no resonances over the entire frequency range. So whatever you do, you have the entire range available for a measurement. Let's talk about force. And we improved the high force capability by more than 100%, up to 50 Newton. 50 Newton is the highest force currently available for conventional tabletop DMAs. Why is this important? When you want to measure a large sample, you don't have to grind it down. You don't have to modify your material. You can measure your material as it is. You have enough force available to bend it and get a reasonable strain out of it. And of course, you can address new applications, such as a simple tensile test. And I want to show you one example related to this. What you see here is a measurement on a carbon fiber reinforced polymer. Everybody can do this in a three-point bending setup. But this test was carried out in tension mode. So with a high force capability, and we used here nearly 50 Newton, it's possible to stress a material with high forces and get a reasonable strain out of it, which means we get a reliable measurement result. We see the development of the E prime going down with temperature, and above 100 degrees C, we see the impact of the glass transition. Something which was not possible in the past, carbon fiber reinforced polymer in tension mode. High forces are good. Low forces are important as well. And we improved at the same time the low force range by a factor of 5. Which means we can do now tests down to 1 millinewton. And when I say we can do tests down to 1 millinewton, I mean that we can do tests down to 1 millinewton. Because the resolution and the sensitivity of the instrument is, of course, much, much higher. Why is low force range important? Some people want to measure thin films or a single fiber. And having this low force capability available, you can do this without damaging the sample, without breaking it during a test. So we have an instrument which was extended in the high and in the low force range. Let's talk about user interaction. And the main point, the main contact point between the instrument and the operator is the software. So let's focus on this one. And the 303 has a new developed smart software, which means you have tiles in the software which allows you to do standard tests in the most easiest possible way. This means you press a tile, and all the instrument settings are already predefined. Whether you want a temperature or a frequency sweep, this is simply predefined. And you don't have to manipulate a lot in the software. But some people want to do this. I know the scientists. They want to play around. And we integrated this as well. So we have tab folders inside the software where you can play around, for example, with a ratio between static and dynamic force. You can switch from stress to strain controlled. You can do all of this inside the software. So we have made the perfect combination of the easiest to use software, allowing at the same time complex instrument settings. But we have more implemented in the software. We have integrated intelligence in the evaluation part of the software. We integrated auto-evaluation, which does a fully autonomous evaluation of characteristic temperatures. Fully autonomous means as well fully objective. There is no more user impact on the results as soon as you use auto-evaluation. Of course, you can still play around with those parameters, but you have the tool for it. Furthermore, we implemented Identify, which is based on an integrated database. Identify, for example, means you can carry out a measurement on a reference material, a batch where you know that it's working. And then you have the easiest tool for quality control, because every future batch you buy, you can simply do a measurement, and the instrument will tell you whether this batch matches or not. Easiest operation and easiest evaluation for a complex method like dynamic mechanical analysis. Let's go further on. Instrument operation. This is another thing we addressed. And the first thing is, some people want to do three-point bending. We heard about tensile measurements. We have all necessary sample holders available to do this. Additionally, compression penetration tests are possible, single and dual cantilever, shearing mode measurements. We can do static or oscillating measurements. We can work with a pre-stress, or as mentioned, we can do even a simple tensile test. But we moved this further on. Proper sample preparation is always a crucial thing in a DMA. And we worked on this. You can place the sample inside the instrument how you want to do it. You can do it while you sit in front of the instrument. You can do it while you stand in front of the instrument. You can bring the sample holder in the position you want to have it. There's a wide range of movement inside this setup. And it doesn't matter anymore whether you are a little bit taller or not. You can bring the sample holder in the position you want to work with the instrument. We make the instrument fitting to you and not fitting you to the instrument. Finally, let's talk about temperature. And we extended the temperature range by 200 Kelvin. What does this mean? It means that we can now do measurements up to 800 degrees C. This is unmatched in the field of conventional tabletop units. Why 800 degrees C? When I work with polymers, for example, even there it's important. I think this happened to everybody. You were not careful, and you went a little bit too high in temperature, and your material was molten to the sample holder. It sticks now. But you can do now a simple pyrolytic cleaning. You remove some parts mechanically, and the rest you simply burn off. At 800 degrees C, nothing organic is left anymore. A simple heating test on your sample holder and your instrument is ready for the next measurement. And furthermore, it allows you to address new applications. For example, you can measure glasses, some ceramics, and even some metals. And I have an example with me. This is a DMA test on a nickel-based superalloy. When we look at the results, yeah, we start at room temperature, E prime decrease with temperature, till we reach 400 degrees C. And then we see some shoulders and some steps in the curve. When we look for the tangens delta, these effects get even more dominant. We see it in the red curve. There are additional peaks within the curve. When you ask a scientist what is happening here, these are annealing effects, cluster formations, very small effects inside the materials. And you won't see them with any other thermal method. Here, you get the significant impact on the curves. And watch out, above 600 degrees C, we see the largest effect, the largest peak, which was impossible to be measured before. When we talk about the furnace, we have to talk about cooling as well. And of course, you can connect to this furnace multiple cooling options. There's no need to connect the cooling. So you can run the instrument from room temperature up to 800 degrees C. When you connect the liquid nitrogen cooling, you can go from minus 170 all the way up to 800 degrees C. No step, no break. You can measure from lowest to highest temperature. If you don't have liquid nitrogen available, we have other cooling options. For example, air chillers, which allows you to go subambient. Not to minus 170, but you reach subambient temperatures. Let me sum it up. So we have a tabletop instrument with an unmatched force range, 1 millinewton all the way up to 50 newton. We have the easiest to operate DMA with the most intelligent software. We have a DMA with outstanding flexibility, not only regarding sample holders, as well regarding operation procedure. And we have a DMA which offers the broadest temperature range currently available, which allows you to address new applications. This is the new DMA 303 Eplexor. And we are sure it sets new standards in dynamic mechanical analysis. Thank you very much.